So guys, it's finally here. Halo 3, the biggest game we've all been waiting for, is finally here on PC. It's still in pre-release, but there's so many things from Forge, customization, even the matchmaking. I have a lot to say, including about the hit registration, which is fantastic. So let's jump into the video, guys. So this particular build actually has so many new things. Even the challenge system that has just been introduced. You can go into season, you can see all the season stuff that you could see from Reach. You can go to the challenge hub and it says all the different challenges. So I've been playing quite a bit already. As you can see, you got Halo 3, Multiplayer Completionist, Precision Weapon Master, FNSC Weapon Master, and then Covenant Weapon Master. You got Weekly. It also says available enemies, available weapons. It tells you how to get them. It's really good. I really can't recommend it enough. So for the legendary medals, it's Extermination, Killianair Perfection, Staketacular, Triple Double, Unfriggin' Believable. I'm really happy with the amount of challenges that are in the game, especially the ones that rotate weekly. It seems that there's about 20 to 30 challenges, which is awesome to see. They give around 10 to 15k XP each, which is also really, really good. But let's jump into the next thing, which is customization. The best thing about it is you can actually pick which one you want to add. You can mix and match certain armor types. You got the flaming chest piece for the helmet. So if you actually can know your helmet and you can actually go across, you can have different flaming helmets, which looks insane. Put Haybuster for that. It looks so good. On top of this, there's actually so many new Forge items. So let's jump into Forge and check all the new stuff out. So the number one thing, the really the biggest thing that they've added into Forge is you can actually set items to phase through other items. If you ever did Forge when it was on the Halo 3, the Xbox 360, you couldn't actually place items to go through other items. So now if you click X on an item, you can just go down, set physics, and you can go fixed, phase, and you can actually phase it through symmetry. It doesn't matter, but still if you go phased, you can actually drag it through items now. That's the big thing. You never were able to do that. You always have to start a new round to get things to float into the sky. But nowadays, you can just do that. And that is fantastic. 303 did such a good job adding this into Forge. The next big thing that I wanted to talk about is this big thing. Look at this. 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 Look at it. It's spinning. I can't believe they added elephants. You know, we can have elephants on everything. On everything. So let me just take this all the way out of the map. Just chuck it. You can have battles on Sandbox with elephants now. Not only that, you got Hornet, you got the Transport Hornet, you got the Wrecked Warthog, you got the Warthog Transport, which I've always wanted to see. Just crashes them all down there. Shade Turret. And this one is my personal favorite, the Anti-Air Wraith. One that you could only get in campaign by actually... Oh my god, is it gonna land? Oh, I thought I was gonna do a backflip and land. But the big thing is, you can actually use it. Instead of doing the campaign glitch where you gotta kill this horror guy and then quickly jump into it, you can actually drive it around now, which is absolutely insane. So 3x3, you did a fantastic job. Let's move on to the multiplayer, guys. So, the multiplayer, and what can I say except wow. I honestly thought jumping into this, I kind of speculated that maybe the extra resolution, frames, and field of view might actually increase how accurate the actual guns are. Because Halo 3 is obviously the hardest game to aim in out of any Halo game. The BR is probably the least consistent out of any Halo game, and the sniper is fairly hard to use. After actually playing for about 5 to 6 hours today, I was amazed at how easy it was to actually aim. Maybe because I'm on 150 ping, it was always harder for me anyway, but I feel like I can actually keep up with the best players now when I'm using a sniper. The hit registration is vastly improved, and when I say vastly, I mean vastly improved. I barely got bloodshots even while playing on a high ping, and then when I was playing on 3 ping Aussie servers, I was basically hitting every single shot. It was phenomenal. The BR obviously isn't 100% still. I mean, the BR is probably never going to be 100% accurate. But still, I'm really happy with it. It's an improvement on what it was before. And I feel like this is what it should have been when MCC initially came out and Halo 3 initially came to Xbox One. As far as experience goes, performance is okay. You get about 12k if you play a sniper's game. Otherwise, it's kind of low. And there's still no teamwork XP, which is really disappointing. Hopefully, they can add something in there. Because I can get maybe 10 to 12 assists in a game. And I get absolutely no teamwork XP. They've actually added it now so you can actually see the amount of challenge XP you get. So that's a nice little addition too. I really can't say enough positive things about it. The multiplayer plays so damn well. I can see myself spending thousands of hours playing this, and it might actually become my most favorite Halo game ever. Oh, Halo 3 in the past, I didn't really love it as much as Halo CE because the hit registration was just so poor, especially with me living in Australia. I couldn't really justify making it my favorite game. But now that I can actually play it and it's really crisp and the hit registration is great, I'm loving playing it. I played a lot of El Dorado, especially Halo Online, and I was kind of concerned that Halo Online would be a better game than Halo 3 on PC when 343 or Saber Interactive did it. But honestly, it is such a faithful remaster, reimagining, upgrade, if you want to call it that, that I'm happy with what they've done. And I don't say that lightly, because Halo Online was a ton of fun. The hit registration on the sniper was pretty close to what it is on MCC. The battle rifle is different because hit, scan, projectile, obviously they're two different things altogether. But the multiplayer is fantastic. The Forge has added in so many big things, so many quality of life updates, bigger budget, more items, phase items through each other. They can just hang in the air now instead of just falling to the ground. And finally, I wanted to cover the damn campaign. The campaign, even the cutscenes, look crisper. They look better. I'm going to play the Hog Run on screen now. It looks so damn good. When this comes to Steam and everyone sees how good it is, there is a big chance that Halo on MCC is going to be popular, at least for a couple months heading into Infinite. So 343, there's a lot of pressure on them to actually get this game specifically right. I think they've done a really good job. So when do I think this is going to come out? Honestly, I feel like it feels like a finished game. Everything seems to be on point. There's very minimal bugs I've found, maybe with the battle rifle's hit registration slightly, and maybe fix the XP for teamwork. That'd be really good. What I also saw, there was actually a bug. You can actually turn on the new medals for Halo 3 like you could in the Reach beta. I don't know if that will mean that they're going to overlay the new medals on top of the old ones so you can actually just turn them off, but on the background they'll be there so you can actually earn assists for teamwork. So that's a really interesting thing. I don't think I've seen anyone notice yet. But I would speculate that it'll actually come out very, very quickly after the flight test. And then, honestly, 1 month away from Infinite news and then probably an Infinite beta, there is so much happening for Halo now. It's such an exciting time to be a Halo fan. With everything that's going on, it really makes you think how much is going on behind the scenes at 343. They've been working on almost every single game simultaneously. Then they've had Halo 3 ODST Firefly that has just been announced. They've got Halo Infinite with a separate team as well. I can see why when Sketch said this is going to be the year for Halo, he really meant it. And speaking of new things, the hit registration on keyboard and mouse for sniping on Halo 3 feels incredible. It's so much fun. I'm going to do like a specific keyboard and mouse sniping video over the next couple days. And it feels so damn similar to Halo Online. I know a lot of the Halo Online El Dorado devs, the game basically died. So Halo 3 on PC or just Halo on PC in general could become a thing. So thank you guys, because it's basically all because of you that this has happened. 343 saw how popular El Dorado was, and they realized, damn, there really is a market for Halo on PC, and you've kind of spurred a whole different generation of people to experience Halo for the very first time. But the keyboard and mouse, I really feel like for Halo 3, feels the closest as balance between controller and keyboard and mouse, because the aim assist is slightly lower. I'm going to do a controller versus aim assist and then a keyboard and mouse video all this week, so I'm going to cover absolutely everything. We're going to break it down from a non-biased perspective, and you guys can make your own mind up after watching the entire video. So guys, that just about covers it. We covered the campaign, we covered the multiplayer, and we covered the Forge. The campaign looks so much better, it looks beautiful, I can't really say anything negative about it. I don't think I've ever seen Halo 3 look as pretty as it does now. The multiplayer, the hit registration is so much better, it feels crisp, I can't say anything negative about that either. And you have the Forge, there's so many quality of life improvements, so many added things, extra budget, you name it, I've already covered it so you've heard it. But honestly, I'm so critical of 343 because I want Halo to be the best it possibly can be. They have smashed it, 100%. There's small, very small, minor bugs, which is to be expected from a flight test. But if they can nail the launch of this game, bam, we are in for some really good times ahead. So thank you guys so much for watching. I'm going to do basically an upload every single day this week, so I have so much content to cover. I'll be live over at twitch.tv/mintblitz every single day, grinding out multi-kills, gameplay, you name it. Hopefully when some Halo 3 mods start coming out, I'll cover them too. So a lot of people have been requesting modded content, so I can't wait to see what the community comes up with. But yeah, I'm excited to basically relive my childhood and play Halo 3. If you guys also go into the flight test, leave your gamer tag down below. I run games with viewers every single night, and I'd love to play with you guys. So thank you guys so much for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed today's video, and I'll see you guys again tomorrow. Bye, guys.